Hi, and welcome to the lab safety video of your CH-116 course.
Appropriate clothing for lab. One of the easiest ways to stay safe in the lab is to wear clothing that will protect you from spills, broken glass, and other hazards. Because you are not required to wear lab coats, you need to come to lab in clothing that covers most of your skin. We'll walk you through some guidelines to make sure you don't get sent home. These are both appropriate shirts to wear. The shirt must have sleeves, but it doesn't matter if they are short or long. The shirt covers all of the torso and would provide good protection if something were to get spilled on them. These shirts do not cover enough of the body to be worn to lab. These shirts do not have sleeves, and this shirt does not cover the whole torso. These pants are all perfect for lab. All of them cover the leg down to the ankle, are made of cloth, and do not have holes in them. During the summer months when people commonly make the mistake of coming to lab in short pants, keeping a backup pair of sweatpants in your backpack or car to change into for lab days is a good idea. These short pants, skirts, leggings, kilts, and lederhosen would all be inappropriate for the lab. Most of these do not cover the whole leg. While some leggings do cover the whole leg, the material is easily dissolved by certain chemicals and they should not be worn to lab. These shoes are closed-toed, closed-heeled, and cover the foot up to the ankle, do not pose any kind of balance hazard, and are safe for lab. These shoes, on the other hand, are not so great. These ballet flats would not protect your foot from a spill. While these do cover up to the ankle, high-heeled shoes are not safe to wear in the lab. These don't protect your feet at all. While this type of shoe is allowed, this model does not cover the top of the foot and is not allowed in lab. These are not allowed because they are open-toed, have high heels, and do not protect the top of the foot. Alright, let's go through and see if you can identify what types of clothing are allowed in lab. Alright, what do you guys think? Could you wear this outfit to lab? No, you can't wear skirts to lab. Or swans. What about these pants? Yeah, those pants are fine for lab. How about this outfit? Yes. While the bow tie is probably a little too fancy for what you're doing, you could safely work in that. How about He-Man? No, you can't bring weapons into the lab, and he's wearing hardly any clothing, so that wouldn't cover him. Would Superman here be allowed to cover up clothing that isn't allowed using appropriate clothes like a shirt or jacket? Yes, superhero garments worn below dress suits are allowed, as are tank tops that are covered by a hoodie, shorts, leggings, or tights covered by sweatpants, or skirts worn over any allowed pants.
What else should you do before coming to lab? Read the section in your lab notebook for that day's lab. Understand the purpose of the experiment. Write out the procedure that you will follow to obtain your results in the pre-lab write-up. Being prepared and knowing what you're doing is a key element of lab safety. Let's see what must be done in the lab to stay safe.
Make sure to tie back long hair before you start the lab. Make sure you wear goggles the entire lab period, even when cleaning up or getting reagents. Putting them on the forehead is not okay. Keep personal items away from the lab bench and the floor around your workspace. Your belongings could get damaged, or someone could trip over them. The best place for your things is in the front of the lab below the whiteboard. Food and drinks are not allowed in the lab, including chewing gum. Seal these items and put them in your bag, or just don't bring them at all. Water fountains are available at any time out in the hallway. When using the hood, make sure the sash is below the indicated level. The hood should be used when performing experiments that use flammable or toxic chemicals. Check your glassware carefully for cracks. Cracked glassware can leak or shatter, injuring you or the people around you. When you're getting your chemicals from the stock bottle or container and you accidentally take too much, never return the excess reagent to the stock bottle. Instead, you can ask another group if they need any extra, or discard it in the proper waste container. If you want to smell something, do not sniff the chemical directly. Use your hand to gently waft the vapors towards your face. Never leave experiments unattended. Ask a group member to watch it if you need to go somewhere. There are several broken glass disposal boxes around the lab. Any broken glass should be placed in these boxes, not in the normal trash cans. Other waste, like paper towels or chemicals, should not be placed in the broken glass box.
If you spill something, alert your TA so they can use the spill kit. Broken glass can be cleaned up using the broom and dustpan.
If you spill a chemical on a small area of skin, first, notify your TA. If it is a strong acid or base, they'll help you use the neutralizers located in one of the hoods. Otherwise, wipe it off with a dry paper towel, then flush the skin with water for 10 minutes.
If chemicals get on your face or in the eyes, use the eye wash. First, rinse your face with the goggles still on for 5 to 10 minutes. Then, remove the goggles and rinse the area underneath for 15 minutes. The safety shower can be used for larger spills on your body or clothes. The TA can tell you if this is necessary. It should only be used in emergencies. Fire extinguishers can be used to put out small fires. The fire blanket can be used to put out people on fire. Wrap it around the person to smother the flames. For larger fires, alert the TA, exit the room, shut the doors, and call the fire department. After the lab is finished, make sure you clean your area and equipment. Failure to do so may result in loss of points for that day. Thank you for watching this video on lab safety, and good luck on your first lab!